Helsing boy. Are you stopping for me, buddy? Oh, that's cool. Thanks. Oh, you asshole. You wait now. Are you kidding me? Hey guys, it's Corrales, and welcome back everybody to Euro Truck Simulatore numero 2. It's been a while. I've missed it, hopefully you guys missed it. If you did miss it, let me know that you missed it, because now I don't know that you missed it. I'm just kidding. Welcome back. This is going to be a little mini-series revival. I did get asked by the creators of the game if I wanted to try out the new upcoming DLC, which comes out in May. And I was like, maybe. And they were like, Corrales, it is the Scandinavian DLC. And I was like, hell yeah, I want to try this out. Take a peek at this. My current base of operation is here, in this city. Repeat after me. It is called Malmö. This place here, around here, is called Skåne. And it is the best place to live in Sweden. If you live further north, if you live in this part, you win life. Congratulations. No, I'm just kidding. I live in a little place here called Ystad. And I'm a little bit sad that I didn't add it here in the game, though, because we do have a ferry connection to Poland, to Świnoujście, which is just here on those two peninsulas. So you know what? It is what it is. We do have Gdynia here to Karlskrona, and we have Gdańsk to Nynäshamn, just south of Stockholm. So what I thought, in this little mini-series, we're going to explore Scandinavia, Sverige, Norge, and Denmark. That is how we can say that in a Scandinavian fashion. Sverige, Norge, Denmark. I love it. But I did create a new profile. So, old company is gone. Long gone. This new company is called Corrales Logistics. We have, like, no money. We have no trucks. My level, my rating is newbie again. But I did get this most amazing profile picture ever. This guy looks like Lech Wałęsa, the Polish president, which kind of got Poland out of the communist regime in the late 80s and beginning of the 90s. In life, you win some, you lose some. In this case, we lost everything, but we did gain this most amazing profile picture, so I love it. But anyways, for those who are just new to the game, new to the channel, this is a truck simulator game. You drive a truck. Uh-huh. And I have to ask you guys one thing, okay, before we start. This is how I played it. I have those mirrors, I have these mirrors, and everything is perfect, right? But would you guys want me to have like a side mirror like that so you can see what's going on? Because I mean, that's going to kind of be helpful for you guys. And also the GPS. Vital part of information, I guess. We have the speed, we have the time of day, we have destination, we have like distance to destination and whatnot, money. Usually when I play it off camera, I just use the built-in GPS on the dashboard. So you guys will have to let me know, okay? Oh, it's so beautiful already. This company is called Norrsken, which means Northern Lights. Huh, that's cute. But anywho's, I'm playing this on a Logitech G27 wheel. So let me just try out all the buttons so we didn't forget any things. We have the engine, we have the little parking brake, that works perfect. We have the indicators, they work perfect. You have the little warning thing here. We have the light, the big boy lights, perfect. The vipers, they work. Vipers. We have the horn. We have the flashy lights. I don't have any air horns though, so we kind of need to add that in a later stage. But before I just get rolling, let me just get a cup of coffee, like a real truck driver, and put on my trucking hat, or hat, cap, or hat, and whatnot. Be right back with you guys. Everybody, let's do it. Gear in. No, you know what? Let's first hear the engine sounds. Oh, baby. Perfect. Gear in. Trailer, you coming? Yes, you coming. And you will have to excuse me. I haven't played this game for half a year or something. So there might be a little bit of hiccups and mess ups here and there. I'm gonna hit stuff, I'm gonna cause crashes maybe or whatnot, but hopefully I won't. This game is like kind of like Counter-Strike. You need to practice every single day to get better. Can you imagine? Competitive Euro Trucking. That would be kind of amazing. that this? Does that even exist? I don't know. But anyhow, I am happy that this is back. Hopefully you guys will enjoy it. So if you do, leave a comment, leave a suggestion, hit the like button. It means the world to me. And we're going to see where this can lead us again, because I've missed this game. And look at up ahead of there. There's this beautiful skyscraper called Turning Torso in Malmö. We've got the church as well. And that building behind the crane is called Kronprinsen. You know what? I've spent... Crap, I can't really see the lights. There we go. I've spent so many hours driving around Europe, but I've never really related to any of the buildings we've seen. So this is going to be like just magical to check out the scenery and what I've created. Because so far, what comes to the buildings here, it feels like home. The signs. I'm him. Dude, you have give way. What the hell? Well, the AI haven't changed. I think the sounds and the graphics are a bit boosted, though. You know what? My force feedback on this wheel is just cray-cray. I'm gonna be called Kiralis Biceps because of all that. It's me and Pasha Biceps. Dude, you don't move, please. Thank you. So, now, since this is kind of like a revival of the profile, it's kind of like a new game, the first mission is always on the city you choose to have your home base in. And this basically just deliver something within the city. After that, we need to pick some quick jobs, to earn some money, to unlock the bank, for example, to take a loan, buy a truck, and then just start our own company, I guess. But so far, I'm back. Oh, I love it. I know there's a bunch of you just watching this series, so even just waiting. I mean, I'm still seeing like comments like on a daily basis, like Kiralis, where is your truck simulator? And you know what? Stuff with me, it just comes and goes. Like for the moment being, I'm all into City Skylines. I freaking love that game. I tried to do it daily, but it was just kind of like impossible for me because of the family and everything. So trying to do it like every second day. Hopefully that's all right with you. But that is, you guys seem to enjoy that series a lot. So thank you so much. Honestly, this is just absolutely beautiful. The buildings in the distance, everything just, the Turning Torso, just take a peek at that. Everything is just, oh crap, our turn. Kids, don't try this at home. We're gonna try. Can I make it here? We're gonna make an illegal U-turn. Don't watch this. Don't do it. Dude, you just wait. There we go. I did put on my wipers by mistake. Don't worry about this. We got this. Just do it this. And on the road again. Cramp. The force feedback. You know what? I need to tweak it. Because now it hurts. This company is called NS Chemicals. Let's see how this looks. This is like brand new for me. They've added little peoples in here. Look at that guy. Skip trailer parking. No, they will say. Here is my spot. Oh, crap. Those assholes. How are we gonna squeeze in? Oh, I need to kinda... Okay, I know what to do. Can I go around here? Let me see. Moment of truth. One man. One mission. Can I go around here like this? Don't hit that post. Ay, 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 ay. I don't think we can do it. And that guy is watching. He's like, don't hit my stuff. So, all right. I think we need to reverse it in somehow. Ah, sometimes. The struggle is real, everybody. But you know what? I think, look at this. If I go out here, like this, for example, and then, anybody come in? Here? No, here? No, perfect. Oh, you come in? No, wait. And then kind of reverse into that slot. Oh my god, I haven't reversed in such a long time. This is gonna be such a fail. Can I? Are my mirrors hitting that? No, no, perfect. Like this, like that. Okay. I know I can skip the parking, but this is the most exciting part of the game. This is why we watch this. The whole parking thingy. Come on, you can do it. No. You know what? I think we can do it. Don't worry about it. We're gonna pause here a little bit. There we go. We're gonna adjust the trailer. And by the way, if you can hear stuff in the background, it's just my force feedback, my wheel going absolutely nuts. There we go. Hey, come on. You can do it, Corrales. You can do it. You've been practicing all your life. There we go. Oh, I don't think you can do it. Crapper. You know what? Professional people would do this without a biggie. I'm just gonna check. Oh, we're about to hit that guy. I love my truck. So that means we need to do... Oh my god, this is gonna be like... 5 minutes later. One man. One mission. Okay. No. Everything you can go. Go, 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 Corrales. Go, go, go. You can do it. It's just turning, turning. Perfect. Now... Don't worry about this. I know this looks really bad. There we go. You should just see my disc. Everything on my disc is just moving. There we go. That is what I wanted to have. Now. Ha! Huh. We got this now. Got this, got this, got this, got this, got this. Perfect, perfect. It's coming along nicely. Straighten out the trailer, the truck. Uh-oh. I think we can do it though. I think we can do it. If I just move, let me just here. And then, perfect. Uh-huh. I still got it. No, I don't. Bam, perfect. Press T and this is completed. Job completed, excelente. 4 kilometers driven, earned 375 euros. I take that. It's always something. And now comes the part. This is your headquarters. It looks a little bit ghetto. It's pretty basic, garage. Well, kinda. It may not be much, but it's a start. Unfortunately, there's no trucks here. Once you earn enough money, you can buy a truck. Thank you. Good luck. Thank you. So, let's go over quick jobs. And so this is kind of like a Scandinavian tour. We need to pick something within Scandinavia. We have Göteborg. Växjö, Karlskrona, Växjö, Växjö. There's a lot of Växjös here. Karlskrona, Odense. That's Denmark. Karlskrona, Karlskrona, Växjö. Växjö, Rostock. You know what? I'm not going to look at the prices and whatnot. I'm just going to pick a shipment, maybe to Växjö. Sausages to Renard Logistics. You know what? Yeah. It's a Volvo truck. I love it. Oh, it's a beautiful truck with a little sunroof and everything. How does the engine sound? Well, not that impressive, I guess, but it is something. The horn, it's beautiful. Let's roll. Now, we're heading to Växjö, and this is going to give us a little bit more money, but as soon as you do a few of those little quickie jobs, then you unlock the bank, which you can take a loan in, and that was going to help us to buy a truck, our own truck. And I'm still like thinking, like, what should we buy? Because I'm kind of like a Scania guy. I love Scanias. The only truck I really dislike in the game so far is Iveco or Iveco. I don't know why. I always dislike them, even in real life. I think they look really ugly. I'm sorry for those people who have Iveco watching this. It's just not my type of truck. It kind of looks... I don't know, cheap for some reason. And I live in Sweden, so Volvo or Scania, it's gotta be a Volvo Scania. That's just something we need to have. And also, as you can see, I'm moving around my thingy here, and that is done by having one hand on the wheel and one hand on the mouse. And it's kind of tricky at some points, but I think that is kind of like how we kind of get the most realistic feeling. I could buy those track IRs, and I think I'm gonna do it as well, but for now you just have to do. Look at those buildings. This is exactly as home. Well, I don't live in a place like that, but it looks the same as Malmö. People living in Malmö, they will relate. So let's see here. Copenhagen? No, we're going to Växjö, and that is a part of Sweden called Småland, which is kind of close to Skåne, which is the good place to live in Sweden, but it's not as close. No, I'm just kidding. I love Småland. I've been there. My parents live pretty close to the border of that little thingy. It's kind of like states, if you kind of compare states to in America, like the different parts of Sweden. And they do have a lot of forests there and a bunch of amazing lakes. So I always went fishing there because I love fishing in like my spare time. Haven't really had much time lately, but that is something I loved to do when I was younger, I guess. And also, for those who watched the series before, we had a little, like, this little Q&A. So that is something which I kind of want to have revived here as well. So please, look at Turning Taurus over there. Please just write questions in the comment section below the video, because otherwise it's just going to be me driving. Well, it's still going to be me, but then I have something to talk about, because now I'm just talking pointless stuff, I guess. Ay, 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 ay. It's beautiful. So yeah, just don't be shy. Spam away with questions, and hopefully I'm going to pick some for the next episode, and then just have a little Q&A. This is kind of like a chill, relaxed game. It ain't as action-packed, I guess, but it's a simulator, and it is the best simulator on the market. I've seen many, but this one is the best. Absolutely love it. And what goes for the FPS, by the way, I tried to record this in 60 FPS. And outside cities, like now, for example, I see I got like 80 FPS recording, okay? Within Malmö, I had about 30, 40, 45. And that doesn't work for a 60 FPS video. Well, I could still render it in 60 FPS, but I mean, it's not really point. So it's gonna be full HD, and it's gonna be 30 FPS. Hopefully you guys don't mind. It still kinda looks good, I guess. Because I don't want to cut down on the graphics. That is something I could do, I guess. But I think it's something to do with cities. What was that? A cat. A dog. A cicchione. I don't know. We have those... I don't know what those birds are called. Those, like... They run super fast. I think they fly as well. They got those, like, big feathers sticking out in the back. And they're kind of small. It looks like kind of like a... I don't know, we call them fasan in Swedish. And they are all over, like, south part of Sweden. And they're like the most stupid bird ever. They run over the street, and if they see a car coming, they just stop, and they look at the car, and then they get killed. I have no idea how many of them I have killed, and they've ruined so many car parts for me that it's just nuts. I think they're called a fasan in Swedish. For those who speak Swedish, you know what I mean. It's a little colorful bird with feathers, and they run super fast over the roads. Crap, I'm just trying to remember the English name, but I can't. So it is what it is. Volkswagen Golf. Oh. What you guys think about, for those who just tuned in to the game, what you guys think about this so far? Do you guys like, yeah, this kind of looks cool? Oh, sorry. Sorry. Going back to this. This is what I mean. The revival of the Faily series. No, but honestly, when I played this before, I didn't really crash that much. I did pretty good. Destination. Trip information, by the way. It's Monday. Time? 5:30 p.m. Alright, sorry. 3:30 p.m. 152 kilometers to the destination, arrival time 2 hours and 25 minutes. And don't worry, it's not that, like, this video is going to be 2.5 hours. This is kind of like a speed up time. But anyways, what else is going on in Kiralis's life? For those who just watched this series on the channel, you might have missed out on stuff. So let's see here. Oh, it's the ocean. It is beautiful. Did we pick Växjö or did we pick Göteborg? Crap, I don't know where I'm heading. But anyways, we are pregnant. Well, mostly wifey. So we're getting another baby, which is kind of going to be arriving. Arriving. She is due to October this year. So that's going to be amazing. I'm going to be a dad again. And I'm super happy about that. So really looking forward to that. What else? We did buy a new house. Is this my turn? Yes. We did buy a new house, by the way. So we're going to move in July. And that's going to be just amazing. Finally, I can have faster internet. I can start live streaming again and whatnot. Because at this point, you know what? I got fast internet. The problem is I get this little quota thing. So I can't pass that, otherwise I won't have enough for YouTube and stuff, and it just sucks. They've been promising me faster internet here for like forever, but it just doesn't seem to come, so it kind of like sucks. So I'm gonna have fiber optics in the new house, so that's gonna be so awesome. And live streams. Nobody coming. I'm going. Vekwe, this way. See, this is what I mean. This is the bushy place, and it's beautiful over there. Trust me. If I would pick a place to live in, besides the best part of Sweden, which is called Skåne, I think I would pick Småland. Maybe not Växjö, but just somewhere, because it's so bushy, and it's those little small cozy lakes all over the place, and I don't know, it's just cute and I don't know, bushy over there. So yeah, new house, new baby. Also, there's a bunch of people asking about Minecraft on the channel, and especially like survival series like Hermitcraft and whatnot, and honestly, I'm just bored of survival Minecraft. I don't think I can do it anymore. I've been playing that game. Oh, see, this is what I mean. Lakes. Look at it. It's beautiful. I've been playing. Oh, it's rain as well. I've been playing Minecraft for such a long time. So, survival and stuff, just gathering stuff. I've been there. I've done that. And it wouldn't be fair playing, for example, on Hermitcraft, uploading it and just be happy about it, because I know a lot of you guys would watch it. I don't think it would be fair, because I wouldn't do it with joy, if you know what I mean. I would just do it because I have to do it, and nah, they would be just believing, letting you believe that I still enjoy it, but I don't. I just think it's so boring. I love building stuff. That is something which I always gonna do in Minecraft. I'm gonna build stuff. That is something which I like. But the survival part, I've had it. I've honestly had it. No more. I will still do Y versus Minecraft as soon as wifey feels better, because now she's pregnant. She kind of fix. Well, she fix. Yeah, she's getting thicker. But she kind of feels dizzy sitting in front of the computer screen and stuff. So. Can't really record much with her, but as soon as she gets better, we're gonna resume Y vs Minecraft. That is the only survival series I'm gonna have on the channel. Truly sorry for those people gonna like, where is that? Where? Why? I'm sorry. It is what it is, I guess. Life. But simulator games. Look at the weather, it's absolutely crap. I love simulator games. I need to find more games. As I've mentioned in the series before, I've been thinking about picking up Flight Simulator. But it's so hard. It's like so many buttons, and I can't. I don't know how to press the buttons, and I have no problems taking off in Flight Simulator. But once I'm up in the air, I have no clue what to do. I just look at the scenery and then I crash. So it's just gonna take a while, I guess, until we get a game like that up on the channel. Dude, come on! Don't have all day. What is wrong, buddy? You turning? Oh, okay. Perfect. See you, bud. That's awesome. Now I don't have to overtake that guy. So, I don't know. We're just gonna rock and roll with some Euro Truck, some Minecraft, some City Skylines, and there's gonna be more games. But I don't wanna, like, just pump out games like a video producing machine. Quality over quantity. Hopefully this is good enough quality though, but it's always a little bit awkward, because now this is super. Oh, camera, let me just see here. How 70 crap. La 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 la. I love it. And don't do that, just stick to the speed limits, by the way, kids watching this. But I don't know how it looks in other countries, because in Sweden we have usually like a little warning sign a few hundred meters before each camera, which kind of tells you it's gonna be a camera coming up. And I cannot understand that though, because then people are like, okay, we need to slow down because this is an area filled with cameras and we don't want to get a ticket and whatnot, so they're gonna keep it secure. But from an economical point of view, it's just horrible. Don't have the sign and then just earn the big bucks, because everybody's gonna be stuck in those, trust me. So I mean, I don't know. How's that? How does it look where you live? Trip information. Almost arrived in Vikwood. Oh, crappers. This is gonna be a quickie. Come on, Corrales. You can do it. Still no crashes. Everything is intact. I love it. Vikwood boy Jönköping. Jönköping is where DreamHack is, by the way. For those who kind of like, oh yeah, I'm gonna watch DreamHack. It's gonna be the Counter-Strike competition and whatnot. Kalmar. Helsingborg. Are you stopping for me, buddy? Oh, that's cool. Thanks. Oh, you asshole. You wait now. Are you kidding me? Oh, this is what I mean about AI. They stop and then they drive. I love it. The guy's still standing there. OMGs. Hopefully the shipment is intact. Otherwise, it's going to be like, uh-oh. Because I won't have excellente on this trip. And you, dude. Are you kidding me? Oh, I didn't have my lights on. That's maybe why. There we go. Lights on. Everything is awesome. Vekwe. Okay, so let's just think about it. 70 kilometers per hour. This is something coming up, which is a giveaway sign. And a light as well. Never. Oh, yellow. I can drive. Vekwe is discovered. Ladies and gentlemen, we have arrived. We even got little like information boards. That is exactly as we have it here in Sweden. Like in those little small cities and whatnot. That is cool. And see, as soon as I drove in here, my FPS dropped to 30. Something about cities in the game. No bueno. Hi! How you doing? How you doing, lady? Are you impressed with my track? So yeah, Vekwe is discovered. Here we are. Oh, no way, is that a little billboard? Let me... Are you kidding me? That is so awesome! I'm sorry, buddy. Let's go. It is those small things in life, I guess. Is he still standing behind me? I think he is. There we go. Perfect. We're out again. On the road again. So far, I'm truly very impressed. Even though it rains, we don't really see much of the beautiful scenery around here. But I am so impressed about the buildings and whatnot. Because, I mean, this is exactly as Sweden is. Even like the little trees as you can see here. That is exactly how we have it. And yes, we have a lot of roundabouts in Sweden. A lot of them are really pointless as well. But we do have them. Can we do like a little roundabout tour? Oh, I think it's gonna be sunshine. Oh yeah, I'm the roundabout pro. Dude! Okay, the AI is... I don't think the AI is that improved. There's still a bunch of assholes. Here's the company which we are meant to go to, by the way. I'm sorry, I just got carried away in the roundabout and kind of forgot about that. But yeah, for the next episode, everybody, Q&A. Ask your questions, spam away. I'm gonna be happy. Something logistics. Alright, so where's my parking? Renar Logistics. In Vekwe. Is it here? This little guy standing there. I feel sorry for you, dude. And this is kind of like a backing up stuff again. Crap. You know what? We can do it. There we go. Perfect. Full speed ahead. Turn the wheel. Oh yeah, baby. That guy has the most shitty job ever. In the rain. God help him. I'm sorry, my force feedback is just going mental and it's really struggling. Did we make it? Oh no, we need to have it perfect. We need to have it perfect. Don't worry about this. There we go. And adjust the trick. I'm happy. Well, it could be better, but it's almost perfect. Everybody, press T. Excelente. We've made it. We made $3,400, which is not much, but we're getting there. Slowly. Level 2. And now I can pick a skill. You know what? I'm on long distances. Nah, you know, high value cargo. I think that's going to boost us the more money, most money. Fragile, just-in-time delivery. You know what? Eco-driving. No. High value cargo. There we go. We get 1 point in that. Everything is perfect. Kerala's newbie, level 1. Thank you so much for watching this revival. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Hopefully you guys want to see more. If you do, hit the like button. Spam away in the comment section suggestions and questions. And you know what? I'm going to see you guys in the next one. So stay awesome. Keep trucking. This is Kerala's. Over and out. Bye-bye.